Okay, in this problem, you are given 5 microfarad capacitor, which I'm calling C1, that's connected across a 9-volt battery to begin with. So the capacitor C1 gets a certain amount of charge Q from this 9-volt battery, right? So I can figure out what that Q is. Q is C1 times delta V, and the delta V is this 9 volts. So Q is 5 microfarads times the 9 volts, right? So there is a 45 microcoulomb of charge on C1, right? So it's fully charged, and then the problem says you disconnect the battery, right? You disconnect the battery and then take this fully charged capacitor and you connect it across an initially uncharged 3 microfarad capacitor, right? So I've just put a switch here just to say that before the connection is made, that's how it looks. And once I close the switch, we see that this capacitor C2 is connected across C1. So there is going to be some charge redistribution, right? Some of this charge is going to go away from here and some of it will be depositing over here, right? And maybe I'll take off one more here. So you'll have, I'm not saying they have the same charge, but some charge will leave here and some charge will go here. Just to say that it's not the same, I'll just leave some different charge here. So there is a new charge Q1 prime. I'll call it Q1 prime on C1, and the charge on C2 is Q2 prime, and the redistribution of the charge will stop when the potential difference across either capacitor is the same, right? Because if you take any two points here in the circuit, whether you go through this capacitor or you go through this capacitor, the potential difference should be the same. It's path independent, right? So the redistribution of Q1 prime and Q2 prime will be such that the potential difference across these two points is the same, right? So I can write it like this. I can say, first of all, the redistribution is such that Q1 prime plus Q2 prime, the total charge on the two capacitors is basically coming from whatever charge was there on one of them, the Q1, on C1. So this should equal Q, right, which was the 45 microcoulombs is distributed between the two capacitors. And how is it distributed? Well, it's distributed such that the potential difference across both of them is the same. And I'll say it's delta V1 prime. Prime is just saying it's the new voltage across C1 is the same as the new voltage or new potential difference across C2. Right? So it's these two concepts, that the charge, whatever charge was originally there, is redistributed on the two capacitors. And once all the redistribution happens, the potential difference stays the same across the two capacitors. Or you can say these two capacitors are in parallel. So there, the voltage should be the same across them, okay? So writing down these two equations, one that says that the total charge is 45 microcoulombs, which was on C1 to begin with, and the fact that delta V1 prime is equal to delta V2 prime, and I can write the potential difference as charge over the capacitance for C1 and charge over capacitance for C2. And simplifying this, I can express Q1 prime in terms of Q2 prime, right? So I have two equations and two unknowns. Substitute for Q1 prime from here in here. Then you can solve for Q2 prime and then come back and get Q1 prime, right? And when you do that, you end up getting Q1 prime is equal to 28.1 microcoulombs, and Q2 prime is 16.9 microcoulombs. So we can quickly check that the sum is indeed equal to 45 microcoulombs. And if you substitute, we can get delta V by either taking Q1 prime from here, divide by C1, which is the 5 microfarads, right? Or take Q2 prime, divide by 3 microfarads. Either way, you get your new potential difference, delta V prime, to be equal to 5.63 volts. So we were asked to calculate this, the voltage across, the new voltage across the two capacitors, and then here is the two charges on the capacitor after connect them in this form. Right. After you reconnect them, that's the delta V prime and that's the Q1 prime and Q2 prime.
Made with DoodleCast Pro.